Hi everyone, welcome to SK Math Training and Tutorial Center. So today, I'm going to show you how to find the area of some irregular figures in general. Therefore, as you know, in the previous grades, you are familiar how to determine the area of any figure in general. Especially in the previous grades, you are familiar how to determine the area of any regular figures. But today, I'm going to show you how to determine the area of any irregular figure as a whole. So, in order to determine the areas of all these, the very important lesson that is used to find the area of such figure is a definite integral. So, previously, in the previous my video, I have already shown how to determine the integral of any function. That means we have already seen what is indefinite integral and how we are going to calculate indefinite integral of any function. So we can generally find the indefinite integral of any mathematical problem. Whatever the integrand of the function, we can find the integral based on different technical finding of this integral. So today, particularly, I'm going to show you how to find the integral of the definite integral, how to find the area of any irregular figures. So to show these, let's consider one particular example that will clarify how to determine the area of any irregular figures. So this is the first example. Let's evaluate what is the integral of these dx. Let's find which is x is running from minus 1 to 1. How can we determine the integral of this problem? So this shows that this is a particular example of definite integral. Therefore, in order to find or in order to solve this problem, first of all, you have to be careful whether the integrand of this function is continuous or not on the given interval. That means, as you know, the integrand of this problem is f of x is equal to 1 over x, and the given interval is minus 1 to 1. So always, particularly in the case of definite integral, always we have to be careful before we calculating the definite integral of this problem. First of all, you have to check that whether the integrand of the given problem is continuous or not on the given interval. As it continuous on these, that's the main question. If it is continuous, we can find the area of these irregular figure, which is already bounded between the curve of this problem and this interval. But if it is not continuous, it is impossible to find. That's the main concept. Therefore, as you know, this function is not continuous on this one. It is not continuous on this because it is discontinuous at x is equal to 0. Is that? That means it is discontinuous means that if you replace or if you plug any real number from this on x, it is always defined except 0. Because 1 over 0, as you know, it is written, as you know, 1 over 0 is doesn't exist. We're going to see what is the physical meaning of doesn't exist. But anyway, for now, doesn't exist. So, and hence, it is discontinuous at 0. Therefore, what will be the area of this? So, as you know, in order to find the area of this problem, let's first of all draw the graph of this problem. Now, the graph of this function is given by just like this one. Now the area of this is given by this one. This is the graph of 1 over x. Now the region is, there is, let's assume that there is minus 1 here, and let's assume that there is 1 here. So The importance of the definite integral is determining the area of the region which is already bounded between the curve of the function and the upper and the lower limits of this integral. So now it is given by like this one. Therefore, the graph of this problem will be just like this one. And for this case, that means for this one, it will be just like this one. This is the region. So how we are going to find the area of the region, this and this. So in order to determine the area of this one, so based on one of the important properties of definite integral is we can describe this in the form of this one. So the integral of minus 1 to 0, 1 over x dx, plus the integral of 0 to 1, 1 over x dx. We can describe this problem in the form of this one. That means, this means it is the region this one. This means it is the region this one. Mean that both of these, this is area, this is area 1, is another area, A2. So, as you see, this part and this part seems to be the same. And when we are finding, this area, you may be just calculating. That means this A1 and this A2. This is a negative area, this is a positive area. But in the case of when we are finding the area of a region, there is no a negative area as a whole. So how are we going to find the area of this problem? Can we find the area of this problem? Now, let's see whether it is exists or not. Therefore, when you come to the case of this problem, this can be described as, this can be described as, mean that it is possible to just close zero from this side. Therefore, we can change this indefinite, definite integral back to what the limit in general mean. So this can be written as the limit of the integral of minus 1 certain constant c 1 over x dx where c is running goes to 0 from the left. That means as we just go to 0 from the left, what will be this? Plus, this can be written as the integral of, this can be written as, this is the limit of the integral of 1 over x dx, and let this be b to 1 as b goes to 0 from the right. Because on this, we can just, now look this one. We can go to from minus 1, 0 to 0, 1. Therefore, we can close 0 from this side. This is right for 0. We can close 0 from the left. Because this function is discontinuous at 0, and hence we have to close, since it is not impossible directly plug 0 on this problem, we have to go from this side and from this side. Therefore, so what's the result of this problem in general? Now look, as you know, this means that the limit of generally, the limit of this integral means that, you know, that is very simple, ln of absolute value of x, which is evaluated c minus 1, as c close to 0 from the left. Similarly, this will be the limit of, the integrand of this mean ln of absolute value of x evaluated with respect to 1b and b is goes to 0 from the left. So, if you replace this problem, now this means that the limit of generally of the limit of ln of, this means that ln of absolute value of c minus the limit of, ln of absolute value of minus 1. Plus, we're going to see how this will be. First, let's find this reason. As c goes to 0 from the left. Now, mind you, in order to determine this result, the Lan of whatever this value in general, lan of LEC, lan of LEC is, let's suppose how this is, but lan of this means that this is given by, this is written as, lan of lim of lan of absolute value of C minus, this absolute value minus 1 is always 1, so lan 1 is 0, it will be, this minus 0 will be this one, as C close to 0 from the left. Now, the lim of this problem, as C close to 0 means that when C is a very, very small number, that will be plugged on this one, any value on this will be, any, as you see, from, you know that on this example, we have this, so we have this one. So when you close to this, zero is here, as you close from this side to zero, from the left, what will be the result? It goes to this direction, that is negative infinity. You see, this is the result. So the limit of this problem means that as it close to zero from the left means that as you go through zero from the left, the result goes to. That means the range value, y value goes to negative infinity, and the result will be this one. This is the result of this problem. But absolute value of this will be positive. So that is positive infinity means that this is diverges. This diverges means that this result not say, we can say that it diverges, this diverges. With similar possible, with similar concept, this also diverges. And hence, in general, the integral of this problem, let's come back on the first example. That means the integral of, one over x dx, which is evaluated from x is running from minus 1 to 1, is always given by this one, and this diverges. This diverges means that since the graph, as you see, the graph of this problem will be this one. Now, since the graph of this problem is just like this one, it is not unbounded on this side, and it is not unbounded on this side, and hence the integral of this problem diverges. So that means in general, the definite integral of some arbitrary functions will be obtained, means that it is obtained means that if the integrand of the function is always continuous on the given interval. But if it is not continuous on the given interval, that means if it is not continuous in the interior of the lower and the upper limits of this integration, now therefore the definite integral of this problem will not be obtained, and as it is, it diverges. It diverges means that it is impossible to determine the area of unbounded region. This region, as you see, this area is not bounded, and since it is not bounded, it is impossible to find the area of this region. So this is all about today's lesson. So in the next lesson, I'm going to show you a very important extension concept of this problem. We're going to see more and more interesting videos how to determine the area of any irregular figures as a whole. So to get more important such videos, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, which is Isuke Math Training and Tutorial Center. Thank you for today.